Hydra.
Okay, hi, Abhishek Agarwal, founder of Hydra. So nearly 26% of US population is currently underbanked as per latest FDIC report, and nearly 80% of world population is underbanked. What that means is current traditional channels in financial world are unable to serve them. A lot of grants and a lot of niche sort of companies which have come up, but there is nothing out there which is trying to solve this big problem, which has existed for a few hundred years. The solution is, what we are trying to do is, at Credit Hydra, is trying to solve that. What it is, it's a decentralized data bureau which sits in front with the consumers on the mobile phones rather than sitting behind the banks as current credit bureaus do. By doing so, they are able to collect much broader consumer behavior data, which allows most of the financial institutions and big banks to serve these people profitably, which usually they cannot in the current ecosystem. To achieve that, we have taken a two-step approach. We are doing a risk model, alternate risk model, which gives a score similar to a FICO, but it's an alternate score. Our API is live, and we have a few customers using that. We have given approximately 3,000 loans using that. And our performance is similar to sort of the mid-level FICO scores right now. Second part of our system is our app. It helps us to collect the data, but we understand the data collection is hard, and people don't want to give us data. So our app is a very intelligent personal assistant. What it does is a lot of people struggle to meet their monthly commitments. And when they don't have enough money, they don't know which bill to pay first. So they randomly end up paying some bills. What ends up happening is they end up paying a lot of finance and interest charges, as well as their credit score takes a dip because they don't pay the right loan. So this app or the smart assistant helps consumers to decide which loan or which payments to make first and what amount. What it does is it ends up saving nearly 50% of the finance charges that most of the people pay. And second, it makes sure that the credit score doesn't take a dent and also helps you to improve it over time. By doing that, obviously the credit score improves and people obviously end up getting traditional loans, but also allows us to collect all their monthly data and in the long run help us to provide that alternate score. One thing which I failed to mention is if you see the API, we actually not only do just the credit scores, we do a lot of social data and all that kind of stuff too. So we are doing a combination of social data, credit, monthly data, and all this. Oh, I'm sorry. Doing that. To tell you a bit about our technology, as you would have guessed when I said decentralized, we are a blockchain company. Though the blockchain we are using is proprietary to us, it's a combination of Stellar protocol and Ethereum. The reason we are doing our own proprietary blockchain is twofold. First, what we want to build a blockchain which can achieve a consensus in a small remote village, which doesn't have internet access connected to the whole big network. A quorum protocol allows us to do that, where village chiefs of 5 or 10 top people in the village can sort of get their nodes, create the quorum, and sort of approve all the loans and all the transactions. The second part is by doing our own smart contracts and our sort of protocol, we can add storage as a component to it using an IPFS, which allows us to do all the data storage at a really, really low cost. And any other blockchain in the market ecosystem doesn't allow us to do that. And last but not least, we understand that data is extremely precious and extremely private. So all our nodes run inside the Intel HGX hardware secure platform. So even our node runner cannot look at the data which is coming to the nodes. Our ecosystem interaction is straightforward. The user collects the data through their phone and it gets stored on the blockchain. And whenever a business wants to sort of get access to the data, the notification goes to the user. He approves the access and then the user gets the access of that. The consumer use case is pretty straightforward. Identity is a big piece, though we are trying to do legal identity, but we understand that legal identity can be an issue, but data identity is definitely possible. We obviously have tokens, and I can talk about that slightly more in the next slide. We allow you to do crypto trading as well as we allow you to store your fiat on the wallet. We allow you to store your financial, social, and other kinds of data easily controlled by you, so that you can share it when needed. And last but not least, as we talked about, we provide credit ratings already. We are working towards providing employee ratings where people, companies are looking to hire. They can look at that. And last but not least, this gig economy has a lot of rating issues. And by collecting comprehensive data, we allow you to do that. Business use case is the same. The only thing I talk about is the payment. So our ecosystem allows to create a sort of pseudo tokens using a fiat, where the way escrow account is set up is the company as well as the sort of our company controls the escrow. So you can create fiat based tokens, which allows all the payments to happen on the network, and you end up only paying 1% of the fees, and all the payments are instant, rather than paying 3-5% fees, which you pay right through to Visa and MasterCard, and then payments take 30-50 days. Our partnerships, we already have a partner in Halo, as well as Kudos in India, and also in US, we are trying to work with CFSI, whose mandate is to work with another bank, and in India, there is a sort of non-profit called Bharat Inclusion. Our team consists of myself. I have 15 years of lending experience with Bank of America, and I have an MBA from Wharton. My co-founder, Pankaj, is resident in India, and he's leading our India effort. And Saurabh is my classmate from IIT Kharagpur, and he's leading our technology. Our competition consists of traditional players like Experian, as well as non-traditional players like Google and Amazon. And our vision is to inspire the international system for the next 5 years. Thanks a lot. Okay, so you're asking why are we using blockchain or what's the interactions?
What's the relationship between this is a
open
protocol or what is your relationship?
So it's our own chain. It's not an open protocol initially. Once we have launched at least 100 nodes, we will make it open for other people to launch. Just because of network security and other issues, we don't want what's happening with US where 6 nodes are in pretty much attached. So we are not. But it's a combination of Ethereum and Stellar from that perspective. We are not doing a proof of stake. We are using Quorum, if you know that. So we are launching that by the end of this month, actually. But we are working with nonprofits. We have talked to 5 nonprofits which are looking to serve this segment. And the idea is to do the launch of the consumers with them, because these are the consumers which are only 26% of the people are underbanked. But if you take millennials plus the underbanked, nearly 40% of the Americans are unable to meet their monthly payments. And they end up making the wrong choice. Actually, Earning would be a perfect partner for us. So we are not helping you to pay. We are helping you to decide what to pay. So if you have few bills unmet and you want to use Earning money, we will be there to tell you where to you should put that Earning money. So we actually are looking for PayActive and Earning to partner with. And actually for Earning and PayActive, it's a perfect thing because it reduces their risk, because we can track where that money is going. Right now, they just have blind faith. From a competition other side, there is no actually payment help app. There are a lot of budgeting apps which tell you where you should not spend money on coffee, but there is nobody actually which helps you once you have spent the money, how you should pay that loan. So we actually, there is no competition from that perspective.
Thank you, Abhishek. Round of applause.